How lovely. I'm swaying here on set. That was the new single, Life is a Beautiful Dance, from sisters Mary and Deirdre Kennedy, to welcome you back. And she's one of Ireland's much-loved broadcaster who's graced our TV screens for almost 40 years. And last year, the long-running nationwide presenter officially retired from her role in RTE, but that hasn't slowed her down.
Oh, no. Now she's swapping presenting for singing, all in aid of Family Carers Ireland. Mary Kennedy, you're very welcome to the show. Is there no end to your talents?
Morning, Mary.
I'm sure, do you know, Simon and Nora, I'm sure there are people sitting at home and saying, my goodness, would she ever get off the stage?
They would never say that.
But I just feel that when you're offered opportunities in life, that you should take them. And the dancing was offered to me. I loved it. And the song came about because Don Meskell, who's a friend of mine and a friend of you as well.
Friend of the show, yeah.
He was sitting at home with his mother in Limerick, and he was watching myself and John doing that dance. The waltz, and he wrote this song as a gift for me called Life is a Beautiful Dance, and it was just so lovely to receive it. And then he asked the hard question, well, will you record it?
Yeah, it's a gorgeous idea, Dom. Would you want me to
dance,
sing?
But what about singing?
Yeah, so then eventually, you know, with much to-ing and fro-ing, I said I would do it with Deirdre, my sister, who's a lovely singer. So we share it. It's half and half. And then we said, well, let's do it for charity. And I'm a patron of Family Carers Ireland, so I have huge admiration for the work that they do. And this is a lovely opportunity to raise awareness and also money, because you can text 50300 and donate to
Family. Isn't it incredible with what's happened in the world this year, Mary, that the focus of the world has shifted to those people who are on the front line? That the doctors, the nurses, the carers, they've become the new superheroes, haven't they?
And rightly so.
And rightly so, because not that they went unnoticed up to that, but, you know, it's changed vastly.
I think also with regard to family carers in this country, I think as Irish people, we have a gene for caring. We really do. It's part of our DNA. And the people that do it in their own homes for loved ones in very difficult circumstances are heroes, as you say, and they do deserve all of the support that we can give them. And, you know, they're finding it difficult at the moment. They save the state $10 billion a year, and they... you know, there are 335,000 of them, so let's help them at Christmas.
And they're at the front line.
They're at the front line as well. Yeah. It's interesting, you're just talking about the family carers connection. Recently, we did a lovely interview with Helen O'Reilly, who had been caring for her 90-year-old aunt during lockdown, and she wrote a book about her tweets of her time. And what I loved about the tweets is you'd be reading them, and often they were very funny, but searingly honest, very thought-provoking as well. And when we were chatting, she did mention the isolation that she feels, and then something like family carers, who are a community just there to reach out, to listen, to put you in touch with somebody else in a similar situation. Yeah. I mean, that's vital when you're on your own.
And to give a bit of support. And because it's been difficult to fundraise this year, services like maybe respite had to go by the board. And that's very, very important for people who really, even to have an hour to go to the hairdressers, things that we all take for granted, or to just go out and get a breath of fresh air. So this is why we have Don, Deirdre and I have done this single. It's available for download on all the major platforms from tomorrow. So,
and what has this year been like for you? I mean, like the rest of us, things came to a grinding halt in March. So how was lockdown for you?
Well, to be honest, it was so busy up to the beginning of lockdown because of Dancing with the Stars, which was wonderful to be very busy in January and to, you know, get fit and toned after Christmas. Yeah. You know the way.
Great excuse, exactly.
Yes. There was a kind of almost like taking a deep breath. And it was nice to just take stock, I felt. And like so many other people, I did a big declutter and, you know, all of those things in the garden. But it was difficult because a lot of gigs, I suppose, that I would be doing were cancelled. But then it was the same for everybody. And I was very lucky in that nobody belonged to me got sick. Yeah. And for that, I was very grateful. And you kind of adapt. We're really very adaptable people as well. Then during the summer, you know, it was just so joyous to be able to see family again and to get out and about a bit more. And I loved, because of all the work I've done with Nationwide, I love this country. And it was a great joy for me to see maybe on Instagram somebody who might have previously taken their holidays abroad.
Yes.
Get in the car, go to the airport and go away. That they were absolutely mesmerised by how beautiful this country is and how much it has to offer. So hopefully the staycation.
They were discovering it or rediscovering
it.
Yeah.
So true. Yeah. You have a very busy family home life as well because you've got Eva and Tom and Owen and Lucy.
Yes.
And congratulations are in order because you had an incredibly exciting week last week. Grandmama for the second time.
I know. Little Paddy now down in Limerick is a big brother.
He is. Bless.
He's 19 months old and he now has a baby sister called Holly.
Oh,
and now she's only just really been born. She only came home from hospital on Friday. And it is really, really nice to... I think people say, you know, when your first grandchild is born, this is something that just put this into your head.
Thanks, Mary.
When your first grandchild is born, it's so, you know, it's so mesmerising, it's so exciting, and it is. But actually, when the second little person comes into your life, you're so conscious of them as a member of your clan, member of your tribe, you know, absolutely dying to find out their little personalities and to, you know, welcome them into our family.
How's your daughter doing? How was her experience in a pandemic giving birth? Because
it is hard.
Yeah, of course.
I was really grateful that this was not her first baby because her husband left her there, was allowed to be there for the delivery, and then had to leave. And the next time he saw her was when he went to collect her and the baby, which means he didn't get to hold the baby or anything like that. Very emotional and very hard. I know that in some maternity hospitals, there are facilities for partners to visit. Mm-hmm. I really think there must be some way around it. It's too hard.
Strange, strange.
Really hard for Eva.
Mary Laura mentioned in the introduction about, you know, you officially retiring from Nationwide. But of course, you haven't slowed down, you haven't stopped. But in terms of facing that word retirement, what did that mean to you? How did you have a plan of how you want to approach it?
No, I'm not good for planning.
Right, okay. That's probably a good thing, though, is it?
Well, it was hard. I mean, the thought of not doing Nationwide was kind of, you know, sad. I felt a little bit sad that this is coming to an end. But then change is good. Yeah. And I have had opportunities this year that I couldn't have embraced if I was still... I couldn't have done Dancing with the Stars, and I would so regret that. It was just wonderful. I really pushed me so outside my comfort zone.
Did you feel outside your comfort zone?
Yes.
Because you're so used to the camera. Obviously, you're just being you, but on a dance floor.
On a dance floor.
Totally
but
different.
I loved the physicality of it, and I loved, you know, the training element of it. Mm. And John is a great teacher, and he and I now, actually this afternoon, we're going to film a little video to add to the
dance very good.
Thing there. You know, it's nice.
One thing that we always get from when we talk to people who've been through that process with that show, instantly their face lights up when they talk about it because they talk about
Dale,
the camaraderie and Dale.
Yeah.
There just seems to be something very special about being part of that that show.
Oh, it's just so exhilarating. It's a real... and for me, like, I was doing it at 65 and people were saying, you know, gosh, you fair dues, and I could do that as well. And I hope people do that. But there's just a real... There's a lovely feeling of celebrating
uplifting.
Your body and celebrating your physical life when you're dancing. And it's tough. But then you go and you get the spray tan. And you get the gorgeous costumes.
And your glitter and sequins.
And
lovely food. Can we ask you about your daughter, Lucy? Because she is a photographer and she tours with your nephew, Dermot Kennedy.
Yes.
And that was all put on hold earlier this year. So, like so many in the arts and entertainment industry, and certainly for musicians that we've been speaking to, an incredibly tough time for them. They've had to go virtual. I mean, how did Lucy get on lockdown with the gigs gone?
Well, it was, I mean, for everybody, it's very difficult. And it has been difficult for Lucy as a photographer because she and Dermot really gelled, you know, and there was a great relationship. There is a great relationship. There's only 6 months between them and they were very close growing up. But now she has developed a print store online, and she's selling some photographs that she's taken from the gigs and also from the Aran Islands, where we go a lot because dear to my sister lives there, and they're flying out the door for Christmas. She's on lucyfoster.ie, so you know,
sure,
there's
you had to adapt.
What are they hearing, Mary, in terms of when they kind of get back on the road? Are they?
I don't know. You
can't make any plans, but
they do look with, you know, hope and aspiration to places like Australia, where they're going to gigs and the gigs are happening. So hopefully that'll happen in the future. Well, it will come back.
It's a matter of time. So what's next for you? I mean, nothing would surprise us at this
stage. But what's next? Are you
cooking the Christmas dinner?
On Christmas Day, do you still take on all of that responsibility?
Well, we share it. Every second year, I do it, and then my brother John does it, and you know, we do it like that. That's fine. I don't know what way it's going to be. This probably won't have the full complement. Yeah. But I do enjoy that. But I'm looking forward to kind of promoting Life is a Beautiful Dance, because life is a beautiful dance and dance is a beautiful life as well. And, you know, it's a good fit. The very ordinary experience of me dancing, the singing and helping family carers. Oh.
And it's all for a great cause. Mary, thank you so much for coming in. Really good to see you again.
So lovely to chat to you.
Happy Christmas.
And to you too.
Long to go now. Thank you, Mary. Yeah,
Mary's single is available to download from all platforms tomorrow. And if you'd like to donate €4, text the word family carers to 50300.
After the break, we're looking at the best of this week's telly, including a very special episode of Gogglebox Ireland. See you in a few.